as a city manager.
So let's compromise. Let's read what the questions are, and they're very simple. I think Dan can make, can speak on behalf of us, because most of the questions were answered. But I just think it would be helpful to get the questions in the record, because we did make that commitment. And there are a couple of members, oh, wait a sec, excuse me. Let me make something. This committee is here to discuss this issue. So
I don't have to do the chairs here for this. We're gonna put that as a question there. See, that's a real question. That's our issue. So we'll get it on the record. Alright, so we don't have to violate anything. The mayor will send it to the appropriate body, which would be either the DPW, and then we'll get the answer. So I think that would be the best way to handle it.
Okay, I guess some of these were just as much for my benefit though than they were for the folks that were in the audience, and that's why, but if that's the will of the committee, then that's the way we can do it.
Well, we can ask that, when we get the answer to the question, then we'll refer back to council as a body, okay? That way, that's just we, I must be honest, and I just want to be fair to everybody concerned. But we don't want to, reopen something that we really close. So I think that would be the best way to handle that. Okay, all right, council, you have, Sean, as I said. Yes.
Just a couple of things. We had, because of a rainout on October 1st, to move the Clark Cemetery arena to November 12th at 9 a.m. We have those same two landscaping crews coming to join us. It's not just Rose Landscaping and Aswan Landcare. I really appreciate the owners of those companies donating their expertise and the time and their efforts to come help us. So we have some time available on Veterans Day weekend to come down on November 12th to Clark Cemetery, room 22 Centennial Avenue, to help us clean up Clark, which is the final resting place for a lot of veterans. We all appreciate it. I'm going to be there. A few other councils are going to be there. A lot of volunteers, a couple of landscaping groups. So you go around, hopefully we can put a big dent in it. Councilor Para, thank you for your efforts. We've already moved down there a few times to do it now. Ahead of time, and we'll just continue that good work. Again, on October 26th, 7 p.m. at the Magnolia Library, there's going to be a forum and workshop for people involved in the real estate and development world, contractors, real estate agents, people who develop properties. From in town and out of town, so the conversation started about how we can do things better around here, how we can streamline our processes and make things more easier to develop and easier to work with the community on. So that's October 26th, 7 p.m. at the Magnolia Library.
Thank you. I just want to put out there that weather permitting tomorrow, Washington Street is going to be ground down again and resurfaced. There was a defect in the asphalt material that was placed down there when we redid it. This is at no cost of the city. This is under warranty through the asphalt company. This will happen tomorrow, Wednesday, and it should be completed by Thursday. If you've noticed, there's been a rippling in the road where it's kind of waving all the way down, and they're going to correct that at no charge to us.
Is that just one section of all Washington?
It's just going to the one section right now, but I made the attention to the DPW director that the other side looks like it's starting to do it too, so we are aware of that.
Thank you. Councilor Ramon.
Just following up in part on the comments that Michelle Dawson made at the very beginning of our meeting this evening, I invite you all to drive, start Mott Heights. Yesterday on Columbus Day, the DPW in the city completed the paving, the final top course of paving. As Michelle mentioned, there are always going to be some wrinkles in this process, and I think it's important that we as a council try to learn the lessons of this betterment paving project when we start on Heights neighborhood, because I think that all of us will have similar challenges ahead of us, that there are other privately owned roadways within the city that are going to need this kind of attention, and to be able to learn many of the lessons that we've experienced over this lengthy process. We should do so in terms of tweaking legislation, or the betterment program, or the checklist, what residents have to go through in order to accomplish this kind of improvement on a tax betterment basis. But I do invite you all to take a drive. Thank you.
Thank you. Councilor Goodman.
So I've got one notice and then two requests to make. My notice is that I wanted to announce to all councilors that the Keep-In Creoles launch date is Friday, October 14th. And at 4 o'clock, something kind of neat is happening at the Council on Aging. The Cater Bus is going to stop by Rose Baker at 4. And Mayor Taken's going to board the Cater Bus along with any of the seniors that want to join them. And they're heading up to Sane Field in East Gloucester. And there's going to be some booths set up to talk about KPN Trail Stewards and all the different ways that seniors can get around to different parts of the community and take advantage of all the trails. So it's kind of a cool thing, and I just wanted to let you know that was happening. I have two requests from the mayor. Number one is a request to the mayor via the DPW director to place a slow children sign on the right side of Riverview Road after number 45 Riverview and before number 55. My second is a little bit longer. My second is a request to the mayor via our school committee appointed member of the Essex Technical High School to request that the Essex Technical High School CFO/superintendent attend a city council meeting in December to discuss their plans and priorities for the 2017-2018 budget season, including the status of current leases. Further, that going forward, that the B&F committee be made aware of future leases on the table, including leases with private investors.
Councilor Carroll.
Thank you. Just a request of the mayor, and this is a repeat. If the lights at Gloucester Crossing, Schoolhouse Road, and surround full of school could be energized. Thank you.
Okay. I only have a couple things. One is we have a board meeting. Councilor, you have that that's next Monday. You want to announce a little bit about that?
Sure. This is a follow-up of the ward meeting in conjunction with the school committee, and the councilor Melissa Cox and myself, representing Ward 1 and Ward 2, will be hosting the meeting Monday at 6:30 at the Veterans Memorial School, and the subject is a presentation by John Pope concerning the elementary school building program and the options for consolidating potentially veterans in East Gloucester School, and the possible questions around the siting of a new school, construction of a new school, and the disposal of the parcels of real estate that are abandoned by the city to the schools. So it's a follow-up. We had a Ward 1 meeting at East Gloucester, and we thought it was important to host something for the veterans school community over Ward 1 Precinct 2. And so Councilor Cox and I went together with the school committee and they're all, of course, invited.
Thank you. Also, on the following Tuesday, we're going to have a joint meeting of the school department and the city council. And we're going to have a meeting at the Amelie School and the library. And so if you have any questions or, you know, about anything to do with the new schools and the budget and the master plan, you know, that would be a good place to do it.
What time is the meeting from?
The other last item, I think the mayor is going to be holding an all-new is looking for volunteers to become mummies. And what that entails is that children will be wrapping toilet paper all around the city council, creating mummies. Now, maybe she wants to, it's a form of passive aggressive, she wants to silence us, but if you don't want to do that, there's other things to do. So it should be a fun time. Every time we have them, it's just really, we haven't done it in a few years. And the children really